We're here with second year men's tennis coach Brendan Kincaid, just to recap the fall season. And Brendan, you guys finished 1-2. You picked up your first win in the fall in 4 years. You were in every match. You know, what did you think about your team's performance in the fall?
Yeah, we had a solid year in terms of, what we were trying to do in the fall. Made some really good progress in terms of, some of the things we were trying to do. And basically, kind of what you said, closing the gap. All our matches were competitive. We're able to pick up a big win at the end of the year to finish things out. And I think that's really important for our guys moving forward and moving into the winter and the spring season, knowing, we've had a lot of close matches and we were able to pull out a really close match at the end. I think it's really good for our team's confidence.
Okay. Also, from a historical standpoint, you had your first two landmark player of the week since joining the conference in 07. You had Seth Hoseman and David Spivey back-to-back weeks. What do you think that shows about the development?
Yeah, I mean, it's always great to get those individual awards, obviously, but those individual awards kind of come with the team success. And as we've become a better team, like I tell guys all the time, if we're a better team, the individual awards will take care of themselves. And I think that's something that is great. For our guys to get a little bit of individual recognition, it's really great for our program, really great for our school, but we have to make sure, we're trying to continue building as a team. It's not about one or two guys, it's about the entire team, and I think they really understand, that aspect of it too. They know they have to be really successful for our team to be really successful, and I think that's the really, positive thing about, taking away individual awards, but also understanding, the big picture of things.
Okay, you want to talk about your team's development as a whole? You have Fujitani at number three, also did well, and then, the rest of the lineup also.
Yeah, he's come in and he's done a really great job. Having two freshmen playing at 3 and 4 and also having them play at two doubles together. They've had, some growing pains, but again, they were both, Midori and Chad were able to pull out a big win for us in the 5-4 match that we played the last match of the fall. So I think it's really good for their confidence, coming into the spring, knowing, they're able to win those close matches. And for Midori, the last match of the fall, he played the best match I've seen him play. And so that's the big thing with him is confidence. I mean, he's a really talented kid. He's going to be able to do a lot of good things. It's just a matter of, getting him confident and, where he needs to be.
Okay. You say play the best at the end of the fall. When do you really start cranking things up again for the spring season to get ready?
Yeah, so the guys have been doing, the captain's practices and things like that, and then they've been doing, off-season workouts and things like just to kind of get stronger, faster, and get ready for a rigorous spring season. We have, 16 or 17 matches total in the spring, and so it's going to be tough, and that's the one thing I told these guys. We're going to play a tough schedule to get us ready for our conference, and so the hope is we play a really tough out-of-season, out-of-conference schedule to get us ready for, making a run at the playoffs and possibly a conference championship. So I think that these guys know, what we need to do, and the one thing I always try to emphasize with these guys is that conference championships aren't won in the spring. They're won out-of-season. They're won in the summer, fall, and winter. So I think if they have that mentality and they take that into their workouts, we're going to hit the ground running in the spring, and we're going to kind of continue the process of building, the program and find out, how good we are in terms of the rest of the conference.
Okay, and that spring season will start March 1st at Washington College, and thanks for joining us, Brendan. We'll talk to you closer to then.
All right, thanks.